Okay, good evening everyone. Today we have a very special guest, which is Shechianu to Josh. He spends too much time in his pool, so he found the time to come, Baruch Hashem. Let's not speak in English just for him. Today was the Yosart of Rashi. Josh, you know Rashi, right? Rav Shlomo Yitzchaki, Rav Shlomo Ibn Yitzchak. Rashi was the one that wrote the Pirush on the commentary. He passed away about 900 years ago. It says before he wrote a commentary on Tanakh, he fasted 613 times. He traveled in Galut, exile, 7 years, and throughout the exile, 7 years, he was traveling country to country, he was writing the Pirush on the Tanakh. There was never a commentary that is so valuable like a commentary of Rashi. So, I want to tell you about something very interesting about Rashi. It says, first of all, his rabbi was Rabbi Yaakov Yakar. If you remember in Sefer Hasidim, it says there was a rabbi with a long beard and he used to go and clean the shul with his beard, sweep the floors. That was the teacher of Rashi. Rabbi Yaakov Yakar, his name was. So Rashi, when he wrote the Pirush on Rashi, when he passed away, it says the malachim come to greet the rabbi when the rabbi goes away because he's learning their Torah. This one malach did not come out to greet him. You know, anybody know his name? Rafael Michael, why? All right. So the malach that did not come to greet Rashi, his name was Chanoch. Chanoch, too far, because Chanoch was a human, became malach. It says Chanoch is from Bereshit.
Chanoch died.
Oh, very good. It says over here in Bereshit that Chanoch walked with God and God took him.
Why
God take him? God made him the Malach. He's the Matatron up there. So Rashi says over here, why did God take Chanoch?
Because he thought that he loved the other side.
Oh, oh. It says over here in Rashi, Tzadik Aya, Chanoch was a Tzadik. Vekar bedato, he was a little bit lightheaded. Right? Lashuv learshia. Hashem was afraid that he's going to make sin. So he said, you know what, let me take you now before you sin. You're a Tzadik, I'm afraid something bad is going to happen to you. Right? Lefikach mirah kadosh baruch hu v'silko. Hashem rushed and he took him to heaven. Chanoch. V'emito koden zmano. So he took his life before his time came. God gave him, for example, 70 years. He died at 35. Example. God knows, I don't know. He lived more, of course.
He lived 300.
Right. No, I'm just giving an example. So Rashi wrote this on Chanoch. So Chanoch said, what right you have to write about me these things? I'm not going to come to greet you. You're right that I'm going to sin, God forbid. It says in the Midrash, when Chanoch, he was a shoemaker. I don't know if people knew this or not. He was a shoemaker, Chanoch. Every time he used to make one nail in the shoe, he used to say, L'shem, Hashem, L'shem, Na'aseh, Na'asliach, L'shem, Hashem, L'shem, Ruch, Shav, Ruch, Shechinteh. That's what he used to do. Every knot he made in the shoe, every nail put in the shoe, he used to make for Hashem. Why? Because so people, when they walk, they should not go in the wrong direction. Because the shoes take in the wrong direction. Right? So Chanoch said, because you said about me these things in Chumash, Rashi, I'm not going to come to greet you. So one rabbi saw this in a dream. So the rabbi says, Chanoch, you got it totally wrong. That's not what Rashi meant. It says, Learshia. What is Learshia? To make other people sin. You're going to make other people look bad in the eyes of Hashem. How? He said, when you have a tzaddik doing all good, right? And everybody's bad around him. So Hashem says, I don't understand. He's a tzaddik. You're all bad. You could have been also like him. So I'm going to punish all of you because of him. Because he's a tzaddik, you don't learn from his ways, I'm going to punish you. So Hashem said, I don't want to punish you. What am I going to do? Instead of taking all of you, I'll just take him and finish. I'm done with it. Because of a tzaddik, Hashem, the Rash says, because of one tzaddik, Hashem punishes the whole generation. Because you see, you have such a great righteous person, why you don't learn from him? So Hashem says not to make this category on the people, persecution on the people, Hashem took away Chanoch. So when Chanoch heard this, okay, now I understand, he says. Now, so it's not against me he's talking. So then he went to greet Rashi. Okay, that's what last night I sent on WhatsApp to everybody, whoever is in the group. I said that please light the candle, Le'el Nishmat Rashi, Rav Shlomo Yitzchaki Ben Miriam. Okay, whoever lit the candle, Baruch Hashem, it's a great zechut for you. And you pray, you make a wish, of course. ברוך לעולם, אמן ואמן.